two men.
Able to convince Darren's 81-year-old mom to let them inside.
It did. In fact, it scared me. I called my older brother.
Shara has memory loss and can't recall much.
My memory is terrible.
She was home alone the other day when a couple of door-to-door salesmen from alarm company Alliance Security landed on the front porch.
So by the time you show up,
yeah, they're gone, and I see the other system.
Shara's son, who is also his mom's caregiver and power of attorney, says Alliance swapped out the old equipment with one of their systems after getting her to agree over the phone to a second contract with Alliance.
I'm calling from Alliance Security, and I'm just calling to verify your account information.
Had you given them permission?
No, I hadn't said anything. I didn't know what I was supposed to do anyway.
You just thought that you were getting more information.
He just said, this man is coming in, my headman or whatever you call him,
okay. And
go over there and start tearing up.
The easy prey, because it's an older lady by herself, and she's calling us at the time and trying to, you know, understand what's going on.
We have a series of regulations in place.
The Oklahoma Department of Labor regulates alarm and locksmith companies. We alerted Commissioner Melissa McLawhorn Houston about Shara's family's complaint.
It's about making sure that they're registered in the state of Oklahoma, they have proper insurance, they're following the rules.
We know the new alarm system was sold and installed by Rhode Island-based Alliance Security, which is fully licensed to be doing business in our state. Here's where it gets confusing. The company that keeps harassing Shara for payment for the new alarm system is a completely different company, Safe Home Security, out of Connecticut. Safe Home is not a licensed Oklahoma alarm company. Its vice president of sales tells the In Your Corner team they purchased Shara's contract from Alliance after the sale, which is perfectly legal. And since they're only billing for services, they don't need an Oklahoma license.
This bill right here coming every month and them, you know, threatening her they're going to ruin her credit is really set off her anxiety.
Safe Home's VP of sales says he's happy to release Shara from her contract, but only after she proves her medical diagnosis and that she was already under contract with a second alarm service company. He also claims this recording of the sales call proves the Alliance rep was patient with Shara and had no way of knowing she suffers from memory loss.
And is there someone you would like us to contact, like an adult son or daughter, to assist your decision in entering your agreement today? Or do you feel comfortable making this decision on your own?
Don't quite understand who you said I needed.
Well, you don't necessarily need anybody. I'm just asking you if you feel comfortable entering into this agreement on your own.
Yes, ma'am.
Like Shara, hundreds of more unsatisfied customers filed complaints against Safe Home and Alliance online and with the Better Business Bureau. In 2007, the Connecticut Attorney General's office sued Safe Home Security and its owner for violations like unfair billing and collection practices. A second investigation, launched by Massachusetts Attorney General, is still ongoing. Back here on Oklahoma soil, Labor Commissioner Houston says her enforcement officers are already looking into the matter.
I mean, I think the most valuable piece is getting her out of the contract.
We'll check back on Shara. Now, alarm companies must display their license number on their paperwork and on the side of their work truck. Remember, anytime you sign a contract in your home, you have 3 days to cancel it. You can also verify an alarm company's license with the Labor Department. To make it easier for you, we've set up a link at KFOR.com. I'm Scott Hines, In Your Corner.